Jacob Farron here. In this video, I'm going to show you how to create a classy bog garden that you and your neighbors can enjoy. If you're a regular subscriber to our monthly video podcast, you might have already seen our bathtub bog garden. We built it about 5 years ago. We had all types of North American carnivorous plants, like pitcher plants, sundews, and fly traps. Sometimes when folks come over to our open houses, they ooh and ah about the bathtub. They get so excited about our landscaping out here in Eagle Creek. Heck, it's just a bathtub with carnivorous plants, but folks really go crazy over it. We recently took it apart because some of the plants outgrew the bathtub. So we'll rebuild the bog garden and show you how you can build one of these for your own garden. First, you need a bathtub. This one I salvaged when we renovated the double wide. You'll also need North American carnivorous plants. Contrary to what most people think, the good old USA is home to over 50 species of carnivorous plants, including the Venus flytrap. The reason why you want plants grown in the USA is because they're tough enough to handle growing outdoors. They'll take the snow in winter, and they'll take the heat in summer. Choose plants like Sarracenia pitcher plants, dew threads, and fly traps. You'll also need a soil mix made up of peat moss and perlite. Use equal parts of each. If you can't find perlite, you can also use silica sand or washed river sand. We prefer to use perlite because it's lightweight and easy to work with. The best time of the year to build your bog garden is in early spring, when plants are just about to wake up from dormancy. You can build it at other times of the year, but if you do it in the middle of summer, you might see a period when your plants don't look so good. This is because they need time to adjust to their new growing conditions. So it's best to do it in early spring whenever possible. When you're ready to go, position your tub in a very sunny location. Bog plants grow naturally in full sun. Now, full sun means 6 or more hours of direct sunlight. This tub gets at least 10 hours of unobstructed direct sunlight during the summer months. Now, don't worry about full sun during the winter months. North American plants go dormant in winter. Now, a bathtub bog garden is just like a container bog garden, but bigger. When you have your bathtub in place, plug the hole, the drain hole that is. I'm using a rock, but you can use whatever you want. The idea is to keep a small amount of water reservoir in the tub. Bog plants don't mind the extra water. Next, fill the tub with your soil. Make sure the soil is thoroughly moist before using it. When you get your tub close to filled up, you'll find another hole in the tub for the faucet. Cover the hole with a screen. This will keep out the soil, but allow excess water to drain freely. As you fill the tub, lightly compact the soil with your hands. Continue filling up the tub until you're a couple inches from the top. After your tub is filled up with soil, position the taller Sarracenias towards the back of the tub. You want the shorter plants towards the front where they can get direct, unobstructed sunlight. Now, all of these plants are still dormant. We cut off a lot of their pitchers, and they're much easier to work with when the plants are dormant than when they're in their full growing season. Once the plants are in place, you can start digging holes and placing the plant right in. And it's very easy. Something like this. This is a Sarracenia rubra jonesii. Just make a hole like that. Unpot your plant. Set it right in. And then cut off some of the extra dead pitchers. If you have a good looking leaf, keep that on because that will help you identify what the plant is. And then just do that for the other plants. The most common mistake people make is putting in too many plants. Our original garden lasted for 5 years before the plants outgrew the space. If you add too many plants or lots of aggressive growers, you might need to redo your garden every couple years. This garden might look sparse now, but it will fill out nicely throughout the next few growing seasons. After your plants are in place, you want to fill the tub with water. To prevent soil erosion when you water your plants, use a handful of pea gravel or bark. Place the gravel or bark somewhere towards the back of the tub where it's not very noticeable. And when you water, simply water where the gravel is. Now, when you initially water your bog garden, you're going to have to be very careful to prevent soil erosion. And you notice that we've already had some soil erosion, even with the gravel. One of the ways you can minimize that is to set the nozzle to a very low setting and keep it on for an hour or so. And this will saturate the entire soil. Another option is to set the nozzle to a mist setting and mist the soil, the topsoil, just back and forth like this. And this too will get the soil evenly moist. Now, if you added small plants to the tub, don't cover the soil with pea gravel mulch because that will smother the plants. However, if you used only Sarracenias or large plants, it would be okay to cover the soil with pea gravel. Again, don't do that if you have small plants because the gravel and mulch will smother the plants. Now, for the first season of your bog garden, you need to be very aggressive about weeding. You'll also need to water frequently. Because the tub isn't sitting in water like smaller container plants, you will need to make sure the soil is always damp. Don't let the soil dry out, otherwise you may lose your plants. They will die when the soil dries out. For more information about growing North American carnivorous plants, watch Volume 1 of the Grow Carnivorous Plants DVD series. Volume 1 contains important information about caring for Sarracenia pitcher plants, flytraps, and other North American carnivorous plants. There are also chapters in the DVD for growing carnivorous plants in desert regions and caring for your plants in winter. Throughout this video, you learn how to build a classy bathtub bog garden to show off to your neighbors. And in the years to come, it'll be an elegant focal point in your garden. Thanks for watching and good growing.